going back into the day in question, you were outside and the family goes back into the house. What happens after you get into the house?
I think that someone asked me a question. I think I said something like, well, ask mom, she knows all the answers. That's when I got slapped. That's when my dad, you know, said he was going to spank me. And that's when I
said, and is it fair to say that he received more of that, more discipline, more abuse?
Absolutely. Without a doubt, he received abuse that I did not receive.
You indicated that it's your impression that the physical abuse stopped. And you said around the time that he dropped out of school or around the time of, I think you said, the arson charge that he had to deal with?
Right. Kind of once he was no longer leaving the house daily and having opportunities to get in trouble or violate the law or, you know, harm property or whatever, the rationale for, like, the more severe beatings was no longer there, so it didn't occur.
So if he dropped out of school in the ninth grade, does that sound right?
Yeah.
And how long would that have been then before the murders?
Ninth grade is what, how old? I'm 15, 16. He's been held back a couple of years, so he's a little older. It could have been 16 or 17.
So a year or two
before
the murders, at least? You never saw any signs that your father had hit him so hard that he knocked him unconscious?
No.
He says in his affidavit that happened at least 50 times. You're not aware of
it? I never saw it, and I never heard about it.
Did Billy ever tell you that that was happening?
No, that's what I mean. When I said I never heard about it, I never. There was one thing in his affidavit where he said that he was knocked unconscious.